Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to It's the Fergusons. It's Monday morning, and I've got to do some tidying up. But rather excitingly, tomorrow morning, I have been invited to the Department of Education building in London to meet with a guy called Robert Goodwill, who is the MP for Families and Children, Children and Families, to talk about the 33 hours childcare. So I'm going to do that. So I was like, what the hell do you wear? What do you wear to meet an MP in a government building like that? Like, I want to come across well. So I've got some very dear friends called Carl and Lee, and they're very, very good at looking good. And I'm not. So I asked them, and I was like, can I just wear like Timberland boots and jeans? They were like, no way. So this morning's a bit of a palaver from the fashion point of view.
Not overly alright.
Why?
Those jeans look rather tight, sweetheart, and there's a gap in between your buttons, and there's quite a big gap between your buttons and your buttonholes.
Well, on the jacket? The jeans are alright, they stretch a bit.
Yeah, but the...
This jacket is quite old. I've got this other one here.
Oh my god. I mean, I just don't think it's a good look for you.
That blue?
You're more handsome than the look allows you to appear.
Oh, that jacket is better, isn't it?
That's looser, yeah. So the jeans are still too tight and the shirt is still gaping at the holes.
So I need a new shirt and jeans. Can I wear jeans?
No. I mean, I think if it's making you choke...
That's not, that was a separate issue. That was a separate issue to
the... It really wasn't. You breathed in so far that your lungs went up your back.
I wore this how many years ago? A year and a half ago I fitted in this. Mm-hmm.
What to did you wear that?
To school, to work.
I don't know. Funnily enough, I don't know what you wear where.
Yeah. Other than the shirt, imagine a slightly bigger shirt. Okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
No, I'm not going to wear a tie either, because it's a bit more casual, isn't it?
Well, I would suggest, firstly, you get a shirt that you can do up. I mean, they... I cannot believe that... See, you've done it again. You've breathed in so far that you've choked yourself.
I've got something in my throat.
Right, okay, yeah, you need bigger clothes.
I think that they've shrunk in the wash.
Well, before you tell me it was the tumble dryer, I have never tumble dried your suit.
No, not the suit fits. The suit's alright, look. It's probably a little bit of grumming room, in fact. I'm just a bit tighter in the waist.
If you bend forward, you're going to split your ass. Don't try it. Yeah, out, honest to God, it's going to split. It is going to split.
I tell you what, she's got a nerve telling me that I need new clothes. I mean, I do need new clothes, which is where I'm going now. I should probably get some clothes and some clothes that fit probably help. I don't think I've put on that much weight, but obviously I have. Day when you have to shop from the next size up. I'm a large. I don't want to be a large. I've been a small all my life. Recently a medium, now a large. Flipping heck. I need to do something about it. Good morning, everybody. Boy, it is early, 6:30, and I'm out of the house. But I'm on my way to meet this Robert Goodwill, this minister, children and families minister, MP in Westminster, which is just really exciting. I'm looking forward to it. Suited and booted. Back on the train to go home. First meeting this morning in the Department of Education. Well, they wouldn't let me film inside because it's a government building. So I couldn't film. And then, after sitting there for 20 minutes, it was cancelled. Which was all good fun. So that was a complete waste of time. I'm pleased that I got dressed up, so smart for the MP. Never mind. Then, my mid-morning meeting was also cancelled. But I found other things to do, it was fun. At lunchtime, I had another good meeting about business stuff, like about the Dad Network, and just trying to advance the Dad Network, grow the Dad Network. And that was very positive as well. So, it hasn't been a complete wasted morning, but a little bit frustrating. Well, we've donned the glad rags.
I've painted about 10 faces on. Never worn so much makeup in my life. I had to Google how to put eyeshadow on.
You look gorgeous. Did you really?
Yeah.
Because this evening we've come up to London for...
I don't really want it in my face like that. It's like under, basically in my chin, yeah.
We've come up to for an award ceremony because we're up for an award, Best Blog. So they're exciting.
Again.
It's the Little London Awards, which is a magazine, and we're very honoured to be nominated, and we're going to have a nice date night. Jen looks smoking hot tonight.
Basically, I've got fishnets on and he can't control himself.
It's basically that.
He's not interested in anything else, just the fishnet.
Fishnet tights and I am gone. Right, well, we're trying to find where we've got to go, so we better go and have a look, really, instead of just wandering around aimlessly in Belgravia. It's very posh here.
It's 11C.
11C.
And this?
That's 11A. We're going to go and look. We've arrived, but a bit early. So that just means one thing. Well, it was a bit embarrassing because they're not ready for us, but that's okay, because it just means that we get an extra glass of champagne before.
Now I feel really...
Why?
I think it's better to arrive 15 minutes early than it is 15 minutes late.
Well, I always thought that you should always arrive late, you know, before it gets going.
You look good there, babe. You don't.
It's because you can't see my rolls of fat.
And I just have had a wasabi peanut. I'm sweating out my nostrils. Out my nostrils. Do not eat these wasabi things if you're at an event, because nostril sweating does not look good.
Do you need a cup?
Nose bag.
Or a towel.
Yeah, one of those nose bags like I had when I went to hospital.
Oh, yeah. Jenny must have been the only person in history to have been admitted to a hospital overnight for a nosebleed. That was it, a nosebleed.
It's not funny.
I
was ill for about a month.
she called her parents up from where we live, about a 4 or 5 hour drive to Derby, just because she had a nosebleed.
No, because I was admitted into hospital. My mum and dad.
For a nosebleed.
Doesn't matter what. But they didn't admit. They obviously thought there was a reason to admit me. I didn't admit myself.
This June, readers of Little London Magazine and visitors to the website have been voting in their thousands.
We're literally right at the back. So if we win, it's going to be a long walk to the front. We went at bloody one, didn't we?
How'd that happen, eh?
Incredible! I've been a bit...
You've been paying to be allowed.
But we did, it was a public vote, and like, so we need to say, we need to say thank you to everyone and anyone who voted for us, because we couldn't be any happier tonight. Like, thank you, it is finally so lovely to be recognised.
4 years, hard work.
Yeah, and finally, you know, people have gone, actually, what you're doing is good. So thank you, we
what
really
you
do.
What you are doing is good.
Thank you, babe. No, couldn't be happier, so we're going to go and have a beer to celebrate. Or more.
A beer or...
multiple beers. Yeah, we're going to get on it. We've got a babysitter for the night, so date night.